Next will be a Thai speaker, which is the venerable monks who from Thailand, from Ramanai Temple, and Phonphon Prasanno. His talk is going to be attaining Nibbana with the mindfulness. So today we're going to learn how to go further to achieve the right direction, which is normally monks are aware of the technique of teaching of the mindfulness. So we learn from three different speakers. So will be interesting to know all of us, all of the monks who are speakers today, will give some idea, technique, and also how to look at the technique of the teaching that we come across in our daily life. Floor for you.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sama sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sama sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sama sambuddhassa. Good afternoon, everybody in this hall. First of all, I would like to thank His Holiness Dalai Lama and Prabodhi Nantamuni, the abbot of Wat Pa Buddhakaya, who invite me to join this seminar. And today I would like to talk about the attaining Nibbana with using the mindfulness. And as we know, all of the speakers today, they have mentioned about nowadays, lots of people, they know the beneficial of mindfulness. And lots of people now, they think mindfulness is not just the way to Nibbana, but there are lots of beneficial when we practice mindfulness. So first of all, I'd like to talk about the mindfulness in Theravada. We believe that mindfulness is like the special tool or the very important tool to reach to Nibbana. According to the Buddha said, he attained Nibbana, and it happened 2,600 years ago here at Buddhagaya. And after that, he gave the first sermon, Dhammacakka Kappavattana Sutra. The critical achievement to attain Nibbana in the Noble Eightfold Path. That is the right view, right intention, right speech, right action, right livelihood, right effort, right mindfulness, right concentration. This gives rise to knowledge, which leads to peace, to direct knowledge, to enlightenment, to scientific society confirm that the meditation can benefit one's health, and it is a meditatory method to attain Nibbana. Subjecting for any observation and experiment in the near future. What is Nibbana? Studying how to attain Nibbana in Theravada Buddhism was found almost 2,600 years ago, and what happened after the enlightenment of the Tathagata. At where he gave the first sermon, Dhammacakkappavattana Sutra, to the one Brahma who later became the first monk in the world. Nibbana is the ultimate good news of Theravada Buddhism, meaning a complete of extinction liberation. It means to go out like a fire and to call. We can apply dibbana to the mind. That means extinguish the fever of greed, hate, and delusion. The three rules of suffering, the function of attaining dibbana is to reduce and finally end all clinging. Once that desire is fulfilled, it naturally subsides and mind clinging to nothing, not ever to nibbana itself. Classification of nirvana in Sanskrit and dibbana in Pali are saupadisa nibbana or kilesa parinibbana, imply that the substrate of life remain, but all kilesa have been entirely extinct. And anupadisesa nibbana or khanda parinibbana imply without any substrate of life remaining. The theory of attaining nibbana, the Dhammacakkappavattana Sutra, quote, Bhikkhu, these two extremes should not be followed by one who has gone for into homelessness. What two? The pursuit of sense of happiness in sensual pleasure with its low worker. The way of whirling ignoble and beneficial of self-mortification, which is painful, ignoble, and beneficial, without wavering toward either of this extreme, the Tathagata has awakened to be made aware, which give a rise to vision, which give rise to knowledge, which lead to peace, to direct knowledge, to enlightenment, to Nibbana. And what, Bhikkhu, is that middle way awakened to by the Tathagata, which gives rise to vision, which lead to Nibbana? It is Noble Eightfold Path, that is right view, right intention, right speed, right action, right livelihood, right effort, right mindfulness, and right concentration. This bhikkhu is at middle way awakened by the Tathagata, which gives right to vision, which gives right to knowledge, which gives lead to peace, to direct knowledge, to enlightenment, to Nibbana. Further, the Tathagata declare the Arya Satya, the Four Noble Truths. The Four Noble Truths, as they really are in their three phases applying to the Four Noble Truths, making the 12 insight. The practitioner may perform according to the function of the Four Noble Truths. For dukkha, suffering or unsatisfactoriness, one shall perform panya, which means comprehension or location of the problem. Second, for dukkha, samudaya, the cause of suffering or origin of suffering, one shall perform panya, which means eradication, abandonment, and the cause of suffering is to be eradicated. Third, for dukkha nirodha, the sensation of suffering, of extinction of suffering, one shall perform, which means the sensation of suffering is to be realized, envisioning the solution. And fourth, the Dukkha Nirodha Gamini Padibada, the path leading to the cessation of suffering. One shall perform bhavana, which means development, practice, and the Noble Eightfold Path. That is right view, right intention, right speed, right action, right livelihood, right effort, right mindfulness, and right concentration. In this note that missing one item in the Eightfold Path mentioned early, one cannot attain Nibbana. The practical path to attain Nibbana, the most popular technique meditation are Samatha and Vipassana, at which date back to the earliest day of Buddhism. This meditation can be explained that when tranquility is developed, the mind develops. And when the mind is developed, the passion is abandoned. When insight is developed, discernment is developed. And when the discernment is developed, ignorance is abandoned. Defined by passion, the mind is not released. Defined by ignorance, discernment does not develop. Thus, from the feeding of passion in as awareness release, from the feeding of ignorance is a discernment release. In Theravada Buddhism, the Samatha and Vipassana meditation are main two, fitting for the right concentration and the right mindfulness, which are in Dukkha Nirodha Gamini Padipada, respectively. For the two meditation, Anapanasati, mindfulness of breathing, is employed to use with four domain in the Mahasatipatthana Sutra. And that is, as a result of combination of the two foundation, there are four bases of mindfulness breathing, and each consists of four branches, totally 16 units. First one, Kayanupassana. It means that you observe your body. Second one, Vedananupassana. It means that you observe your sensation. The third, Chittanupassana, it means that you observe your mind. The fourth, Dhammanupassana, it means that you observe the Dhamma, you learn about the impermanence, and you understand about the impermanence. It is noted that the Kayanupassana and are classified as a Samatha meditation, whereas the rest of them are Vipassana meditation. One who succeeds practicing of this stage can obtain Sotapatthijamakka. The path of stream attainment, the feedback, Mahasatipatthana employing Anapanasati is to first enter into Kanika Samadhi or momentary concentration, then transform to Upajara Samadhi, proximate concentration, result to be able to eradicate four states of Rupajana, which are Vitaka, initial application, Vijara, Piti, and Upeka, and finally enter into Anapanasati. At this stage, the mind has achieved right concentration. Meditation and beginning of scientific scientific proof by searching in the Google nowadays. On 15 December 2018, there are 400 million results when type meditation, 7,000 results for meditation. And if you type meditation and Buddhism, 38 million results for science-based benefit of meditation. However, typing the most common word of medicine, painkiller, there are just 24,700,000 results. Rearranging this number in ratio by using the figure of painkiller as base, they have appeared at the ratio of 33:6 to 3:2, meaning that public answer of painkiller is much less than dose of meditation, and is relate. It assumed to imply that the public consumption of painkiller is less than dose of meditation. Additionally, there are many search from academic journal over the last few years show the meditation and it relate mention can significantly benefit to the health and potentially become prevent an alternative therapy. The scientific study of the benefit of meditation and some of the quote hereafter. Mindfulness based on intervention, ranking from psychology and neuroscience to public health and education, circle become very popular. Many evidence show that mindfulness based stress reduction, MBSR, which was devised in 1979 at the University of Massachusetts Medical Center, is currently used as an alternative or integrative clinical approach for the treatment of psychological issues in people with chronic disease. As behavioral treatment, mindfulness meditation proved itself to be beneficial in order to enhance cognitive balance and emotion stability, including the elevation of the internal body sensation. Accordingly, since mindfulness directly involves both consciousness and attention, the natural of the brain process and those meditative state should show that the mind calms down. For the last 20 years, it is inevitable to claim that there is uncountable evidence in the public domain, such as the academic journal Create magazine, showing that meditation can reduce anxiety, implicity, age, and race basis direction. So this is all that I like to point it out, that nowadays meditation is not just the special tool or important tool to gain nirvana, but meditation nowadays is like the alternative for your happiness. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Venerable Pha Phorn Phon from Thailand. As I say earlier, there are three monks who show the technique approaching the mindfulness, attain nirvana through the mindfulness, and also the happiness, how to work in the changing world, which is, I think it's good to have different approach, which is East monks from Theravada and Tibetan tradition.
My question is to so what is the best object to focus in shamatha meditation?
For For Samatha meditation, you can observe many things. The Lord Buddha, he observed his breathing and breathe out. You can observe you breathe in, you know you breathe in, you breathe out, you know you breathe out. When your mind focusing on just only you breathe in and breathe out continuously, then your mind will calm down. Yeah, so this is the way that Lord Buddha used. So you can practice the same way as to choose the object like the breathe in and breathe out like the main object and observe it.
I have small query from Bhantiji. Among the Pol Pot, how do you distinct between mindfulness and concentration? Because mindfulness and concentration both are the part of the samadhi. So how do you distinct between concentration and mindfulness? One thing. Another thing is, do you think that mindfulness is enough to remove entire defilement? Whether it need wisdom or not. So,
thank you very much. It's a very good question. For the eightfold path, as you asked, can we just focus on only state? Yeah? And I like to say it's according to the Lord Buddha, we have to understand that it's come like a package. It's like a rope that come with the big rope that come with the small eight ropes. When you put it all together, it's going to be very useful, very powerful. So if we start from samasati, or we start from the right mindfulness, then you can develop your awareness. When you got your awareness will develop your wisdom. When you gain the wisdom, it's going like parallel, yeah, like the bird need two wings. If you got only one wing, or the elephant got only one wing, it couldn't fly. Yeah. So we have to go together. Yeah. In Theravada Buddhism, as I mentioned before, we have two types of meditation. Samatha meditation is like the foundation, or if we like to compare, it's like one wing of the airplane. And Vipassana meditation is like the other wings of the airplane. What is about the meditation? What is about the Vipassana meditation? Vipassana is like when we develop our wisdom, when we develop our awareness, we know more, we understand more, and then we can develop our practice. Then we can go to the right way and attain Nibbana at the end. So I like to say that it's come like a package. We couldn't practice only samatha or only vipassana. And as I mentioned before, the eightfold path is come all together. Thank you. The concentration is like when you focus one thing at the time. You focus one thing at the time. You do it frequently. Then your mind will calm down. When your mind will calm down, then after that, you can create the wisdom. If your mind is wandering, it's like your mind lack of power. When your mind lack of power, you couldn't create the wisdom. Thank you.
Okay,